I'd like to thank the spirit of the sacred land, beloved creator. Bless us, grandmother of the four directions. Each and every one of us, beloved creator. Hold us, protect us, beloved mother.
I think that all of us have this longing to know and to understand the great mystery. And I think, and I feel, and I know in my heart that we look around us and sometimes we don't know how to translate that longing. But it's very simple because everything we want to know is right here. This is the key. The heart is the key to that mysterious language. And if we could just bring ourselves into this space right here and allow ourselves to become one with the universe, the cosmos, we are children of our gods. And when we long for them, when we pray to them, when we ask them, they're always answering us. So the biggest thing is to be still. We just don't take the time to be still. And so I can only answer that if we think of the breath, you know, if we just think of the breath as a vehicle of communication that would bring us and would center us, okay, then we're not separate from the great mystery. We're in the motion of the beauty. Thank you.
beloved Creator, you have spoken to us with your passionate words, with the beauty of your being, beloved light of the sacred dawn, beloved mother. As I stand here before you in the beauty of your light, beloved Creator, hold us in the bosom, cradle us so that we may receive your love, beloved mother.
No memberships, save those who know they belong. It has no rivals because it is none competitive. It has no ambition. It seeks only to serve. It is not of itself because it seeks to enrich all groups and religions. It acknowledges all great teachers of all the ages who have shown the truth of love. Those who practice the truth of love in all their being. It seeks not to teach, but to be, and by being, enriched. It recognizes the whole planet as a living of which we are part. It recognizes that the way we are may be the way of those around us because we are the way. It recognizes that the time has come for the supreme transmutation, the ultimate alchemical act of consciousness, change of the ego into a voluntary return to the whole. It does not proclaim itself with a loud voice, but in a subtle realm of love. It salutes all those in the past who have blazing the path, but have paid the price. It admits no hierarchy, no structure, for no one is greater than another. Its members shall know each other by their deeds and being, and by their eyes, and by no other outward sign save the fraternal embrace. Each one will dedicate their lives to the silence of love of their neighbor and environment, and the planet will carry out their task, however exalted or humble. It recognizes the supremacy of the great idea, which may only be accomplished if the human race practices the supremacy of love. It has no rewards to offer, either here or in thereafter, save that of the ineffable joy of being loving. Each shall seek to advance the cause of understanding, doing good by stealth, teaching only by example. It has no secrets, no arcana, no initiation, save that of truth understanding of the power of love, and that if we want to be so, the world will change, but only if we change. All who belong below, they belong to the Church of Love.
In our Mayan prophecy, we are told to awaken. The dawn is here. Awaken. This message was left to us by our ancestors millennia ago, because we need to remember with every day and with every dawn that our beautiful Earth is in constant need of support.
Beloved Creator, thank you to the spirit of the feminine beloved creator. Blessed be. Thank you.